Unfortunately, I have a feeling that this may have been man-made. I'm going to tell you why. In the 10 years ago, I worked for a long period of time with Professor Luc Montagnier. Luc is the guy that discovered the HIV virus. I had the
Oh.
opportunity to work with him. I mean, I used to go to France on a regular basis. I mean, we really work together. We even have a lab together that we
Wow.
run out of my office. So when this happened, Luc stated that he thought that the virus sequence had an area that was identical to HIV.
Yeah. We yes.
And you know, unfortunately, Luc is kind of old, so people thought that he was crazy. So I started to see these patients, and believe it or not, these patients behave exactly like an HIV patient. An HIV patient drops their good cells, the ones that fight, which is called the CD4 counts. In order to have AIDS, like as such,
Has to
you,
drop
as a
really
drop, your
low.
CD4 count has to drop below 250.
Yeah.
Well, our patients that get admitted to hospital come in with counts in the 30s, 40s, so it
Wow.
behaves like a short-term HIV.
That's crazy.
So,
Wow.
whether or not you believe that part of the HIV genome was inserted into this virus or not, I'll leave it to the viewers to decide. The fact is that this virus is extremely similar, at least in characteristics, to the HIV virus. I don't know if it was man-made per se, but I mean,
You have a hunch.
you have to think about it.
You have a hunch that maybe it was man-made, or maybe this virus was tampered with, or they were testing
I
things.
mean, I think that they were just, I mean, if I was to, again, if I was not a conspiracy theorist, I mean, somebody's playing with a virus, they're trying to insert one or another, whether it's for military purposes or non-military purposes, that's beyond this discussion. But the fact is that something went wrong, and that
So
virus kind of got out of hand.
maybe to the public, should we take claims like this seriously? If there's some sort of evidence or some sort of background to the person to back it up?
I mean, absolutely. I would say that, you know, obviously, in order to have any kind of intervention, you need to have, and I can assure you that there must be a lot of intelligence going on that.
Oh yeah.
Because, you know, for a president to call it the China virus, I mean, you know that we're talking about, I'm sure that they're looking deeply into this. And if indeed this is something that was man-made, then somebody needs to pay the consequences. I mean, there is no question about it. We've lost 200,000 Americans for this crazy virus.
Germany is already building in China as we speak. What will it take for you to be convinced as a professional that this is man-made? Just hypothetically, what do you need to see?
Well, you know, again, I would have to have somebody with the credentials like Luke look at the specific, you know, structure of the virus, look at ways to replicate it, and, you know, get into a level four lab and says, okay, let's try to build this one from scratch. Let's get a regular coronavirus because we've known them for a while, and let's go ahead and add this sequence here and see what happens. I mean, I think that would be proof. Of course, if you get all the good stuff, you know, the one that spies get, you know, like like somebody filming them how they put it in, that would be super cool. But no, I don't think that's gonna
And
happen.
you know, there was an article that came out 2 months ago, maybe 3 months ago on Forbes. It has since been removed, just to be very clear about this. But there was a scientist, a Norwegian scientist, virologist, who made the assertion that, again, the virus was man-made because of how the proteins were structured within the virus. And he actually has a study to show that. And I'm sure you understand that much more than I do. I'm a layperson. But, you know, we're seeing stuff like that, and then it becomes so politicized. And I actually shared that article when it first came out, not because I want, you know, I don't even want that to be true, but it's interesting food for thought. And the first reaction to that is that it is anti-Chinese people because maybe it was made in China. And I said, this is not anti-Chinese. I have nothing against Chinese people at all, or the China. I actually love Asia specifically. But I think that people need to be able, that we need to be able to separate, you know, racism from facts or from a reality that we're seeing. So that's kind of just another part that's going on in this. As you said earlier, it's become so politicized that we can't even have certain discussions. And that's partially why you're here, because we want to
And
have
again, I
certain
mean,
discussions.
I'm so happy that we can openly discuss things here, and hopefully Facebook won't take this down, or you know, right. any of the other medias. But the fact is that there is a question in everybody's mind.
Mm-hmm.
Where, yeah. And you know, I have written about coronaviruses. I know, you know, I was in Singapore in 2003 when they have the SARS epidemic.
Yeah.
I've seen patients with MERS. I mean, we know that coronaviruses have lived around for a while. But a coronavirus like this particular one, the one that depresses your immune system to the point of behaving like AIDS,
yeah,
that keeps the question
it's
in my
very
mind.
Suspicious.
Now the question is, you know, so what? I mean, what are we going to do now? The, you know, the cow is out of the barn now, and there is not too much that you can do. I think that at the present time, at least as a scientist, my primary goal is find ways by which I can, one, prevent the illness, two, treat the illness early, and three, make sure that the patient doesn't have any aftermath effects, and treat those when the time comes.
Yeah, if I may add, because I think this would be a good little soundbite right here. You know, we were talking earlier about your father being born in Istanbul, right?
Mm.
And I'm Armenian, so obviously some viewers will know the history between that. But I just want to put it, because this is a parallel between the racism going on now, or the supposed racism going on now between China and America. But here's the deal. If the Chinese government does something that's heinous, that's on the government. So mm-hmm. when my people were murdered by the Ottoman Empire, I'm not about to have a revenge plot against some random Turkish person. My beef is not with any Turkish person.
No.
And you know? And we've seen that. I mean, it's fascinating that you say that, because, you know, every time I go to Israel, I mean, I make the best Arab friends in Israel.
Exactly.
Because, you know, Arabs and Jews get along just fine.
Exactly.
It's just the political faces and the media. Oh, my gosh, media loves the show. So when you have situations like that, just like you said, you know,
yeah.
I have absolutely no problem with any Chinese individual per se.
No.
Even if their country made any kind of viral agent against us. I mean, I have no issue with Chinese people, because they're actually
right.
very nice people.
No,
even if the goal was to attack us with the virus, that would not affect my opinion on individual Chinese people that I'm friends with, or that I will be friends
Absolutely
with.
Absolutely not.
And I think a lot of people need to understand that. And we need to not take things so far immediately and automatically cry racism, or automatically, you know, cry lying.
Well, it's race baiting. What it is?
Race baiting
is for headlines.
Yeah, no doubt.
Yeah, but
about
you know,
that.
But that brings ratings. I mean,
it does. That's
I mean,
what
the,
it is. It's ratings.
Look at the at all the news stations out there. I mean, they love anything that has racial bias.
Uh-huh.
Oh, they like it.
Oh, yeah.
It's good stuff.
What's your go-to news source? Mm.
I don't. I mean,
you don't.
I don't. I mean, I'll tell you. I like the. I do a lot of Netflix. I mean, that's wrong. It is tough. I mean, every day I try to read the news from different sources all over the place.
Yeah.
I mean, same way I read CNN, I will go to Fox. I mean, I try to stay even. It is tough to find an unbiased source.
Oh, God, yeah.
I mean, you can't. You can't. So I try to, you know, look at newspapers from other countries, see how things are. Because even when it's fascinating when you look at, let's say, CNN, and you look at the news here, and then you go and get the international edition of CNN, completely different.
I know.
Yeah.
It is completely different.
It's funny.
It is so funny. Even the same headline is changed.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because of the audience that they have. So instead of me criticizing one or other news outlet, I just try to make sure that I look at things objectively. And just like I look at this virus thing objectively, I don't know if China made it or did not make it.
Okay.
What I do know is that there is a very close resemblance to a virus that we already know, and the way it's behaving, and that
Which
you
is
know,
suspicious.
And that each one of us needs to make up our own minds as to whether you believe this was
right.
a biological war agent or not, on the basis of that.